North Korea's embassy in Beijing issued a fresh warning to the new South Korean administration of Moon Jae-in, warning Seoul against strengthening the security alliance with foreign powers like Japan and the United States. The statement comes a day after North Korea tested a ballistic missile that it claimed could be mounted with a large-size nuclear warhead, and capable of reaching the continental United States and U.S. operations in the Pacific. In this video, Defense Updates examines the North Korea's missile capabilities, and analyzes if U.S. can intercept them or not. Let us first understand what North Korea has, then we look at three systems of U.S. which can intercept these missiles, and draw an unbiased conclusion. So, let's get started. Here is a list of known North Korean missiles along with their capabilities. North Korea went on to embark on a program in the late 1980s to build a new missile. It is known as the Nodong, and has range of 1,000 kilometers. Its likely target is Japan. It's a single-stage missile. The type of Nodong-1 was the country's first multi-stage missile. Based on satellite photographs, independent think tank the Federation of American Scientists, FAS, believes the first stage is a Nodong missile and the second stage is Song-6, which is a short-range missile. Type of Nodong-1 has an estimated range of 2,200 kilometers. The Musudan, also known as the Nodong B, is an intermediate-range ballistic missile. Its likely targets are Okinawa, Japan, and U.S. bases in the Pacific. U.S. Missile Defense Agency estimates they have a range of 4,000 kilometers. The Type Nodong 2 is also a two-stage ballistic missile, but is a significant advancement on the Type Nodong 1. The Center for Non-Proliferation Studies puts the range at 6,000 kilometers. If the Type Nodong 2 becomes successfully and it reached its maximum estimated range, its range could put Australia and parts of the US, among other countries, within range. Let us now look into three US defenses, which can intercept these missiles. The list is ordered starting with least effective and moving to most effective system.
Number 3.
Ground-based Midcourse Defense, GMD, is the United States' anti-ballistic missile system for intercepting incoming warheads in space, during the mid-course phase of ballistic trajectory flight. It is a major component of the American missile defense strategy to counter ballistic missiles, including intercontinental ballistic missiles, ICBMs, carrying nuclear, chemical, biological or conventional warheads. GMD is administered by the U.S. Missile Defense Agency, while the operational control and execution is provided by the U.S. Army, and support functions are provided by the U.S. Air Force. GMD has its share of hits and misses. The latest test conducted last year was a failure. On April 30, 2014, the Government Accountability Office issued a report stating that the system may not be operational anytime soon because its development was flawed. It says the GBD missile is capable of intercepting a simple threat in a limited way. About 3 years down the line, most experts believe that for higher success, 4 to 5 GMD interceptors will have to be launched against a single incoming missile.
Number 2.
The Aegis Ballistic Missile Defense System is a United States Department of Defense program, developed to provide missile defense against short to intermediate range ballistic missiles. Aegis BMD is designed to intercept ballistic missiles post-boost phase and prior to re-entry. It enables warships to shoot down enemy ballistic missiles by expanding the Aegis combat system with the addition of the ANSPY-1 radar and standard missile technologies. Aegis BMD-equipped vessels can transmit their target detection information to other systems and, if needed, engage potential threats using either the SM-2 or SM-3 missile. SM-3 missile having range of 2,500 km and speed of Mach 10.2, will be particularly effective in this scenario. 5 Ticonderoga-class cruisers and 25 Arleigh Burke-class destroyers are known to be equipped with this system. Some of these vessels are currently loitering near the Korean waters. Like U.S. Carl Vinson is accompanied by the USS Wayne E. Meyer, an Arleigh Burke-class guided missile destroyer, as part of the carrier strike group.
Number 1.
TOD has been recently made operational and is deployed in South Korea. Terminal High Altitude Area Defense, TOD, is an anti-ballistic missile system, which is designed to shoot down short, medium, and intermediate range ballistic missiles in their terminal phase. TOD uses a hit-to-kill approach, that is, the missile carries no warhead, but relies on the kinetic energy of impact to destroy the incoming missile. A TOD battery consists of at least 6 launcher vehicles, each equipped with 8 missiles, with 2 mobile tactical operations centers and the NTPY-2 ground-based radar. The TOD radar is an X-band active electronically scanned array radar developed and built by Raytheon. It has an operational range of around 200 kilometers. The missile has a speed of 8.24 Mach or 2.8 kilometers per second. Being deployed close to North Korea, and designed specifically to counter these types of missile, the TOD is the best bet for United States. North Korean missile tests have been unsuccessful many times, showing that it has long way to go before mastering this technology. Since US has 3 layers of missile defense in place, the North Korea will need at least 8 to 10 successful launches to overwhelm them and have a decent chance. Looking at the poor success rate of missile launches, North Korea may have to launch around 15 to 20 missiles. Any current launch of missile by North Korea takes 1 to 2 days of groundwork and lots of activity in the launch pad. Any preparation of launching 15 to 20 missiles will not go undetected, hence probability of sudden attack is very low. US will have decent amount of time to prepare for interception, giving it better chance. Also, since the missiles are land-based only and North Korea hasn't yet developed concealed underground launch facilities, they remain vulnerable to preemptive precision strike by aircrafts or cruise missiles. US may choose to destroy these missiles in the launch pad before the takeoff, when these are most vulnerable. In either case, US will have good chance of taking down these missiles, either on ground or in air.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. Kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.